Master, you and I grew up in the same hometown. We grew up going to the same church. When did you go from relying on your dad's faith and your mom's faith to relying on your own faith?
Really, when I came to college, I was on my own. I had to make a choice for myself. Am I going to continue to invest in God, invest in Jesus Christ, or I'm going to go to the world? And I decided to keep walking in faith. And it's a blessing that there's so many outlets here to continue to grow my faith and continue to have fellowship with other believers. Yeah, definitely. So when I came to college, that's when I felt like, all right, this is more like me and God, and instead of it's not anybody else, it's just me and Him.
Tell me a little bit about what it's like to play football, all right? And to carry the ball. What do you like best about carrying the football?
I like just running up the middle, running up the gut, and just plowing through, you know? I also like the camaraderie with the teammates, because it's so cool how there's so many different people from different backgrounds who all can come together and work towards, you know, a goal. And it doesn't matter, like, all those are my brothers, even though, you know, I try to influence them in the faith, even though a lot of them are not in that area, I still, like, love them like family. I think God has put me in a place, you know, where I can have a platform and just help grow the kingdom. So it's been good.
I think I remember your first big run at Ohio State, like one of the first times you got the ball. You went 33 yards, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And do you remember that? What did that feel like to go 33 yards, you're number 33? What was going through your mind?
That was pretty cool because it's my first game, freshman year, and I didn't know it was 33 until at the end. I was like, man, that's crazy. First touchdown, you know, at the collegiate level, 33 yards, 33. I wear number 33, so that was pretty cool.
I know why you wear number 33. Why don't you tell everybody who's watching why you wear number 33?
So, you know, Jesus was 33 when He died on the cross for our sins, for all humanity. So I wanted to play for Jesus Christ, so I decided to keep that number. It's been a blessing that coaches allowed me to keep that number and still have it, even though somebody else might have had it. Sometimes, like during bowl season, people will do like jersey swaps with each other. People always ask me like, hey man, let's swap jerseys and stuff. I'm like, nah, I gotta keep this. This is like 33, I don't know, I have an attachment to it.
What scripture do you use to help encourage you, to keep you going?
John 16:33, I tell you these things to the enemy, you may have peace. Take heart. I've overcome the world. You have trouble in this world, take heart, I've overcome the world. So I think that's like the verse for me. It's always kind of been there steadily, but there's been other verses too that's kind of helped me along the way too, but that one.
You know, briefly, what's the most exciting thing for you about playing football at Ohio State?
Going down that tunnel, you know, preparing like pregame and getting ready for the game, getting hyped up with the guys. That's where like everything comes together, all the work that you've done, and probably going down that tunnel before the game, going out to the stadium probably be one of the best experiences, yeah.
What's the key to being an excellent running back?
I think it has to do with like your mind. So you just gotta have a mindset like, I'm going in here and I'm gonna do all I can to make it through the game with, you know, excellence. I just feel like you gotta have a mindset that's relentless, and you can't be timid. You just gotta attack.
I remember the day when you got hurt. There are probably people that would like to know, you know, how's Master doing? What would you tell them about how Master's doing? And
you know, trusting in the Lord that He's taking care of me. You know, I'm not worried about anything. And it's weird how this kind of happened. I thought I was going to miss spring initially, but you know, all this happened. I hate this happening. People are going through these things with the virus and everything. But it's weird how that happened, and I'm really not missing spring practice, all canceled. So I'm just basically healing right now. And you know, this time has really helped me to dig deeper in my relationship with God and seek Him and have those quiet times we're talking about.
So being in such a high profile position, you know, running back for Ohio State, how do you avoid becoming prideful or all the attention you get?
Usually when I'm prideful and I start to get in my own head and start to control every situation, that's when I don't want to be in that that type of mindset, because it just doesn't end well for me and my health. So I just always want to trust in the Lord.